This movie outlines the use of some of the most important preferences in Media Pro. You can find the preferences in the Media Pro menu on Mac and in the Edit menu on PC. Additionally, there's some settings for how your thumbnails and your previews are built that are found in the Edit menu on both Mac and PC. Let's take a look through some of the most important of the preferences, starting with the General panel. This first item governs what happens if you simply launch the Media Pro application. If you use one single master catalog or a small set of catalogs, then this is the setting you're probably going to want, rather than to have it open a new catalog each time the program launches. When you double-click, this is going to switch views between the thumbnail view and the media view, the big single image view. For most users, this is going to be the way that you're going to want to have the double-click work. Potentially, though, you might want to have it open the image in a light table or launch the Creator application, although I believe that for most people, that ends up being kind of a frustrating experience. Tooltips show you what the particular tool will do, and that's a handy thing when you're learning the program. Show warning when removing items gives you the chance to either confirm or cancel when you're going to remove an item from the catalog. The autosave item here lets you save your catalog automatically at some specified time interval. I often find that I'm using my catalog just to browse my images, and I don't actually want to always save the changes I make to it, but that's really up to you. Field names governs what the metadata fields are called and whether those match up with the terminology used in Adobe products or in Phase 1 or in the IPTC standard. So let's take a look here in the info panel, and you can see that the fields change name. Here's the IPTC version, here's the Phase 1 version, and here's the Photoshop version. In each case, the values in the field remain the same. It's just what the field is called. So you should set this up to be compatible with whichever program is doing most of your raw file adjustment. Dimensions should be set to whichever way you typically like to think, inches, centimeters, pixels, etc. The inspector key gives you the ability to hover over an item and hit that key and see some information about that particular picture. The next preferences are for media rendering. There are three tabs: images, raw images, and how fonts are rendered. In the Images tab, you have a control over how images are resized. I suggest you probably want to choose bilinear. You definitely want color match checked. Alpha channel is only important for people who are going to be outputting images with alpha channels directly out of Media Pro. This transparency color item governs how images that were saved with transparency are displayed in the program. The light table warning settings govern where the clipping indicators start showing for highlights and shadows when you're in the light table. In the RAW tab, we govern the behavior for Media Pro and how it renders RAW files. There's an entire other movie that describes how to get the rendering in Media Pro to match the Capture One rendering. The simple version is this: if you're using Capture One to convert your RAW files, then set this to Phase 1. If you're using Adobe products and you're saving as DNG, you want to make sure that you have Use Embedded Previews if available. Media Pro can also catalog your fonts. I suggest that font name is probably the right setting for thumbnail view, and in media view, the extended character set is probably the right setting as well. Here's what those two look like. The vocabulary editor lets you create an approved list of values for any of the different types of metadata fields that are shown here. So you could, for instance, in this case, have a list of approved names for credit lines, and you can even have multiple different lists that can be useful for different collections of images. if you're working in an environment where you want to make sure that the data is always entered in exactly the same way, you can even hit this constrain button. And what that does is it keeps the user from being able to enter in this case, a credit line that is not part of this list. If you want to add a new name to the list, you just hit it right here and type it in. If you'd like to create an entire new list, you hit the plus button up here, give it a name, and then you now have a fresh blank list. I could have also created that list starting with one of these other groups as all of the base values. Media Pro allows you to set your own names for the labels that you can assign when you're browsing your images, and you can also set custom colors by clicking on the color picker and setting a color here. If you get an arrangement that you like, you can export those settings to a little XML file, and on a second machine you can transfer that file over, and you can set those settings by simply selecting that XML file and opening it up. This is very helpful if you want to make a couple of machines look and behave in the same manner. The final preference panel allows us to set some applications as helper applications that become only one single click away from any one of your images. You add an application to it by hitting the Add button, and then go find your Applications folder, and then find the application that you'd like to add, select it, and hit Open, and then that now becomes part of the list. Once that's in the list, if I want to right-click and send an image over to that application, it becomes really easy. The final thing we'll look at here is the preference for thumbnails and previews, and it's split off into the Edit menu because it's actually a preference that's about this catalog only rather than the way Media Pro behaves across every catalog on this machine. I suggest that you build your thumbnails at 640 pixels, which is the largest size that Media Pro allows, and that you use the medium quality, which is a good balance between quality and file size. If you're using Capture One to render your images, it's important to have this unchecked. You can have it checked if you have a catalog of JPEGs or TIFFs or DNGs that you've made with Adobe software. The Media Previews allows you to create a larger version of the image and store it with the catalog, which is quite useful if you're going to do slideshows, say, when you're on the road. You again have three sizes and a choice between low, medium, and high, and once again I suggest you use large and medium as the setting. This display preview at all times tells Media Pro to show the preview and not to show the original image file, which really speeds up the display, but of course it's only showing you at largest a version of the picture that's 1280 pixels. This is really, again, this is quite useful if you are going to be on the road and you want to show those images, or if you really just want to arrow through your images as fast as possible while in Media View. If you like a particular group of settings here, go ahead and save it as the default. And note also here, as it says on the bottom of this window, that creating these settings only tells Media Pro what to do the next time it builds a thumbnail. It doesn't tell Media Pro to go out and rebuild thumbnails, so that if you found, say, that you were originally set on variable and now you want to be set on 640 pixels, you want to make these settings and then use the rebuild item command that you can find up here in the action menu. Select all images that have a small sized thumbnail and rebuild them, and you'll now see that they have a larger thumbnail in the catalog.